There's got to be something down there. Astonishing. This architecture predates the rise of Eastern Orthodoxy. Belt buckle. Decorative, but strong and functional. It appears to be part of a military uniform.
I have left my wife in the care of these physicians. The sickness became exactly what we feared as her skin turned to scales and she lost all feeling in her extremities. They say there is nothing that can be done for her save for give her relief from the pain and ease her passing. But she must be kept far from the city, far from me. My wife will die, and I will never see her in this world again. I will hurry to the next to meet her.
Looks like I need to connect that weight to the platform. Golden necklace of incredible detail. Whoever made it, it's the equal of anything found in the Empire. that should hold. Just need to find a way up. We are crippled by our isolation. We have with us the combined medical knowledge of the Empire, a millennia of learning that tells us how to treat every ailment. But here, on the edge of the world, the lack of one simple flower leaves us helpless. I cannot do much for the afflicted. I know how, but I cannot because we have hidden ourselves away. These people and many more that follow will die needlessly, all to keep our secret hidden. Pray the prophet is right when he says that it will be worth it in the end. An old codex. Looks to be a treatise on the connection between the body and the mind.
the water won't be safe
Hello
to drink.
There.
Not until we clean the corpse.
Greetings, River.
Greetings.
There's always the old cisterns.
You didn't have to risk your life to fight with us, but you did.
No need for formalities, Lara Croft. You've earned our trust. Hello there. Many of our people worked the mines for the Soviets. Even after we drove them out, they died of a strange sickness.
Hello there. The smoke from the fires spooked the animals around the valley, but the deer seem to be returning.
Something's back there.
I knew the risks. It was only a matter of time before the city guard caught me. By day, I must pull gold and other ore from the rock until my fingers bleed, all to increase the wealth of Kitezh. By night, we do penance, ask forgiveness from God and the Prophet. They hope to save our souls, to rehabilitate us. I bow when they expect me to, put on a mask of regret when they remind me of my sins. But when they let me free of this place, I will take my pleasures where I can.
Huh?
pair of gambling dice. Common thing for soldiers, but these are a little more opulent than most. Hold on. This one has 6 on most of the faces. Find a way to raise the cart. It worked. Glad it's still standing. Byzantine knowledge of mining and metalwork.
The wealth of this valley continues to reveal itself like a flower in bloom. Every year, new buildings rise from the wilderness. We have produced a generation of artisans, astronomers, and philosophers that rival anything back west. But with any great city comes crime and rot. Many thought we should have put these sinners to death, but the prophet would not hear of it. He believes all men can be healed, and so we keep them alive, teach them through hardship and scripture. I do not share the prophet's faith that they can be redeemed, but at least they will serve the city and those they wronged.
Father, did he return from the tower?
Great. Seems to be a map of some sort, but I can't quite read the word.
Lara, may I speak with you?
What can I do for you?
We need food and shelter for those that can't fight. We'll make emergency rations from dried boar and mushrooms. It's better than it sounds, but I don't think I'll be able to gather nearly enough. If you could track and kill a Razorback, as well as bring the rest of the ingredients, we might be able to keep everyone fed. For another day, at least.
Yes, of course.
I'll be here. And thank you. How goes the hunt? Will these do?
Yes. Yes. I'll start drying the meat, but this... this should be enough for now. Thank you again, Lara.
Glad I could help.
You're making great strides, young ones. I almost believe some of you might be passable hunters someday. But here is where we begin to separate the wheat from the chaff. Today, while the sun is up, we stalk deer. Their meat, their skin, antlers, even their bones are what keep us all alive. Respect the deer, for it is as close to God as we are. Find them by their bedding, where the grass is pressed flat, or near berry bushes where they feed. Strike true. Don't let it feel a moment of fear or pain. Remember, I will be judging you, and whoever brings me a stag will be judged most favorably. We'll have to rebuild half of the upper village when the invaders are gone.
I can read this now, and it's pointing somewhere. Followers of the Prophet fled to the east. The journey was difficult.
You'll never find a finer meat than boar. As black as the soil and twice as rich. But hunting the damned things is an unpleasant task, to say the least. Now that the sun is up, we will hunt as a pack, working together to take down a boar. We will strike from the hunting blinds around the valley, for we can spot the boar in the dense undergrowth without being seen. And you do not want to be seen. At least it's not raining. None of you, not even I, want to deal with that cursed razorback.
Thank you.
Rivka joined the Prophet because her husband, a Rus nobleman, was a believer. When he died on the journey north, she stayed with the Prophet, pondering what her place was amongst the believers. When she saw the valley, she knew she had found her purpose. She dreamed what Kitezh could be. She laid those dreams out to be built. It is because of Rivka that Kitezh became not just beautiful, but livable.
they think all of this comes from? The natives don't look like the source to build on that scale.
Civilization.
Did we really lose a full company when they broke through into the ruins?
Not only that, but they lost the rescue party.
Well, let's hope we don't attack them next.
Storm's coming in.
Thank you. find any more of those gold coins? I think they're getting suspicious. And they need to vanish on short notice.